Democrats are reportedly rallying behind Senator Elizabeth Warren as their best bet to take on President Trump in 2020. But is she the candidate to rally the Rust Belt and convince blue-collar states to vote blue? Joining me now to debate is former presidential advisor to former Presidents Clinton and Obama, Dr. Susan Johnson Cook, and Media DC political analyst Ron Meyer. Thank you both for joining us. Susan, I'll start with you. Is she the person to take on President Trump?
I think Warren warrants strong consideration. I think she is definitely one of the ones. I mean, you know, when we have a candidate, we rally around that candidate and we make sure that not only she, but she has the support that she needs. She's strong. She's politically savvy. She's a senator. I think she's one of the ones who warrants strongest consideration.
Okay, Ron, do you agree?
Well, I'm sure I'd love to agree with her. From a Republican's perspective, we'd love to have Senator Warren be the nominee. I think she'd be even easier to beat than Secretary Clinton was. If you look at these Rust Belt states, you really think someone like Senator Warren, who has basically only been a college professor before serving the United States Senate and not passing any substantive legislation, will appeal to places like Wisconsin, Minnesota, Ohio, Pennsylvania. I mean, I just don't see it happening. I don't see someone with her values appealing to that part of the population. If you look, she's really a democratic socialist, and she's not like the populist like Bernie Sanders is, where he sort of has this union appeal. And I just don't see how they're going to win over these Trump voters. And by the way, in these states that we're talking about, these Rust Belt states, we've seen 300,000 new manufacturing jobs in the country, and most of those in the states that we're talking about. So I have a really hard time believing Senator Warren is going to be able to go to those states and say, we need to get rid of President Trump, and what experience she has in the economy to get it back going when it is actually getting back going in many of these states.
All right, and you mentioned
totally
some of those.
I totally disagree with you, Ron.
Hold on one second. Mm-hmm. Let's pull up this map here because we want to break down some of these numbers, and then I'll let you respond here in just a second. Some of these states to watch in 2020 that did help tip the scale for President Trump, then candidate in 2016. You look at Michigan, President Trump had 47.3 of the votes compared to Hillary Clinton's 47%. In Wisconsin, Trump had 47.2 compared to Clinton's 46.5. And then Pennsylvania, Trump had 48.2 compared to Clinton's 47.5. So you're looking at a small margin of numbers there. Ultimately, though, people did go out and vote for President Trump. And you look at, to Ron's point, the economy and how well things are going right now. Dr. Johnson Cook, do you really believe that some of those states would tip in favor of Democrats?
Well, totally. I mean, like you said, it's a small margin, so it can tip either way. But I think it's not just the economy people are looking at. People are looking at the separation of families. People are looking at all the things that are not going right with this nation. And I think Senator Warren is going to be front and center for that. So I disagree with Ron in terms of whether she can do it or not. She certainly can, and that's what strategy is about. That's what political strategy is about, that where we're weak, we surround her with strength. But she certainly has been strong and out front from the beginning. So I totally disagree with you, Ron.
Well, listen, Susan. And I think that people on the coasts and maybe in the suburbs care about Trump's Twitter and some of these things and his personality and all that. The people in the Midwest, they don't care about that stuff, not nearly as much. They care about what they care about being employed again. You're seeing steel factories open up for the first time. You're seeing unemployment hitting record lows for almost every major demographic. And so I have a hard time believing that Senator Warren is to be able to go out there and make a case for anything. In fact, I think that if Senator Warren is the nominee, President Trump will be the first Republican to win in Minnesota for the last 50 years. If you look at the numbers in Minnesota, they're closing. He's doing rallies there. I'd put that as a state to watch. If they nominate someone like Elizabeth Warren, anyone from the coast, I think President Trump can even expand Republican margins in the Midwest.
Look, time will tell. Ron Meyer, Dr. Susan Johnson Cook, we appreciate both of you joining us this morning.